Everyone, and we are back with round number 7. We had a lot of issues. It's mainly because the Smash servers are being overloaded, but yeah, we are now back. We got the confirmation from Smash that they fixed it and should be all clear. So we hope that we will not encounter any more issues. I mean, in this quarantine times, it seems like people are playing a lot of online tournaments, so there's a lot of issues with that. But yeah, we hope that we won't encounter any more, and yeah, we're here for now with round number 7. I'm Philip Schulz and I'm joined by Martin Wagner.
Hey, what's up?
And yeah, we are watching Bert Wolters, as you can tell on the screen, and he's currently 5-1 and he's playing a pretty interesting deck. Like, it's not something too much out of the ordinary because it's variation focused, but it's definitely not a straight ADP. In fact, he doesn't play ADP at all. It's pretty close to what we saw earlier on stream. A straight Zacian version with like Jirachi and some kinds of stacks. So I'm pretty sure Bert also plays the Lilith Poker Doll and the Duskmane Crossma. I'm not 100% sure about that. He plays one Lucario Melmetal tag team. So yeah, it's basically straight Zacian, and then there's some tech cards for different situations.
Yeah, I really like that that like new iteration of this of Zacian, because the card is so strong on its own that you don't really need to have the ADP to support it and give it the extra price damage. Of course, it's super super nice if you get it off, but maybe you have to debate whether it's worth it or not to like make your deck a little bit more maybe clunky to fit in the ADP and the water energies to get the like the extra price card and the extra damage, or if you just want to go straight Zacian and be as consistent as possible. I'm not quite sure, but really interesting to see.
Yeah, I think a big selling point of the deck is also that the early game isn't as linear as with the ADP deck, because in ADP you always attach turn 1, pass, attach turn 2, auto creation, and then in turns 3 and 4 you are trying to end the game already.
And if Bert gets a battle saucer of the Stellar Wish, the game is already over!
No, not again! Wow. So Bert Wolters, the King of Donking.
He does it again.
Yeah, we've seen him do it quite a lot of times. In Malmö, we had him on stream where he almost did it, but then he whiffed one card to not get the donk.
He did it on the last international stream. Yeah, he did it like twice. That was super crazy.
Yes, so Bert Wolters, the King of Attacking, very early and donking. And yeah, I was about to say that this deck is more versatile than the ADP, because you can do different stuff early on. You can maybe go for an aggressive Zacian like Bert did in this game. Of course, it's broken when you can donk your opponent, but it can also be good in other scenarios. And yeah, like, you can do other stuff. Like, you don't always have to use the GX attack. You can save it for the late game. You can do it for one energy against stuff like Malamar. And it's just a lot of versatile options in this straight Zacian build, basically. And yes. However, unfortunately, we didn't get to see it play out too much.
Yeah, that's unlucky. But sometimes that's just what happens when you play, like, I assume a control deck. You don't find a lot of basics without the supporter on your first turn.
It very much looked like he was gonna play against the Cincino Mill variant. And yeah, it just ended up in a quick donk. That's just how it goes sometimes. So let's see if we can jump into another game.
Yes.
From what I can see, Tord's game hasn't started yet, so maybe let's switch over to Tord's channel and see if we can catch a game there.
Yep.
And yep. Here, I'm just gonna adjust this first, but yeah, it looks like they just started, and we will be seeing round number 7, Tord Reckliffe facing off against a Malamar Mewtwo deck.
This I think he played the same matchup in his last round when he played against Nico, who was also playing Malama Mewtwo, and Todd lost, unfortunately.
Yeah, we wanted to put that on stream. But yeah, luckily we didn't, because we finished so fast that we didn't have time to do it. And yeah. So yeah, Todd lost that and was very upset about it.
What?
And then now we see the Nightwatch coming out, shuffling back in some cards, and trying to set back Todd a little bit. But I think in general this is like quite a fine matchup for the ADP position, because everything that, like, if you because you can put the Mewtwo's into one-shot range, and all the tech teams will be one-shot by the Zacian eventually. So if you get through an early game that is kind of rough, you can pull it out in the end. And I think the later the game goes, the better it gets.
Yep. And Todd here didn't use his GX attack yet, while his opponent already got two Malama and got an attack going, so
That's unfortunate. That's an unfortunate draw. He missed the metal energy.
Yes, and like one thing to mention about Todd's deck is that he is playing four energy spinners, so he did increase his outs for energies quite considerably. So it's very sad that he couldn't find anything here. Also opted to promote the ADP right away and not go for the Jirachi. Maybe that could have found him a spinner. And yeah, now he's in that rough spot where he also doesn't, where he also has six trainer cards right now. So he
probably wants to thin it out a little bit, maybe play the quick ball as well.
Yeah, exactly. Because if he uses Interpret Sword here, he might very well run into even more trainers, and a Poltergeist from Mewtwo. Oh boy, three more trainer cards. This is terrible. If the opponent just gets his Gengar into the discard pile or on the board, he can use Poltergeist, and that would almost certainly mean the game here.
Yeah, that's true. That would have would give Todd's opponent a really, really huge advantage.
Yeah. Also, alternatively, he can just go for Pale Moon GX, discarding both water energy from Todd's ADP. Perhaps.
Yeah.
Yeah, perhaps preventing it from using his GX attack altogether, and definitely preventing it from using it next turn, at least for the full value. So, it's looking really tough for Todd here.
Yeah, because now Todd needs to put down some Shrines of Punishment to fix the numbers for him. If he attacks with Zacian, he will only be dealing 230 damage, and yeah, he needs the shrine as soon as possible to start ticking away at the Mewtwo.
Yep. And yeah, I mean, generally one metal energy would be enough for Todd to use his GX attack, and for one, the extra 30 is basically fine in this matchup. So he basically just has to pray that his opponent does not go for the Poltergeist, because if he does, then yeah, Todd has an 8 card hand. If six of those are trainers, then it's a knockout, and we know that all eight actually are trainers.
Oh, his opponent's actually settling for the Venom Shot, maybe not wanting to risk that, like, that Todd doesn't have six trainers in his hand, and
yep,
he would be wasting an attack. So he's just going to KO the bigger threat for his Mewtwo in the long term by going for the Venom Shot on the Zacian. Which is also fine. Like, his opponent can't know that Todd has like 8 trainer cards in his hand, so
yep.
However, probably going for the safer play.
However, this opens up the option where Todd just attaches an energy now, goes for the Altered Creation, and the next turn he can cast the Malama up, take a knockout on the Malama set, charge up with another Zacian, and then if he also gets the Shrine of Punishment, he can chip away on the Mewtwo's, and yeah, then take the game very quickly that way. So if he had used Poltergeist, he could at least definitely guarantee that he can take the knockout next turn, because if Todd had three trainers, that would have already been enough to take the knockout with Nightwatch next turn. So it feels like
that's also true.
Feels like the KO would have been pretty guaranteed, and like this way Todd will definitely be able to use Ultimate Ray.
Yeah, as we see, going for the switch into the Jirachi, yeah, his Good thing he plays a lot of stations, so yeah, you want to like I think it's kind of interesting that a lot of lists have been playing four Zacians and three Jirachi, but it kind of makes sense because Zacian is just so good, giving you that plus three whenever you need it. And also you can just go, yeah, if your opponent targets down your Zacians and you only play three and one is prized, you run off them out of them rather quickly. So it makes a lot of sense to play as a four off rather than and then just cut the Jirachi counts back a little bit and go heavy Zacian.
Just an amazing card in general. Also, like opening Zacian is usually really nice because it doesn't get knocked out as easily as a Jirachi.
Yeah,
So,
that's also true.
yeah, we saw that the opponent got like a turn two Nightwatch right away, and Todd opened had the Zacian he opened, and it could tank a hit, and Jirachi would have just gotten knocked out right away, leaving Todd with a definitely weaker board. And yeah, now Todd has the
I'm
option.
really interested in seeing like what Todd will go for. Now he has even more options with the double custom catcher in hand. Yeah, so now you have to commit to one play, and it's probably going to be the Altar Creation because it's just so good. But we'll see.
Yeah, the Altar Creation is really good, but he doesn't have any damage modifier right now, so maybe he just wants to go for an Ultimate Ray. But nope, for Altar Creation it is.
Yeah, he really would have liked to see the Shrine of Punishment this turn.
Yeah, for sure.
If his hand gets manied away and he doesn't get the gust, then he will only be taking three prizes because the Shrine of Punishment damage, if the Mewtwo gets knocked out by Shrine of Punishment, you don't get to take an extra prize card. So, he really would have liked to see that. And yeah, if custom catchers get manied away, then maybe he will be only taking three prizes on this Mewtwo, but it shouldn't matter that much since his opponent benched two tag teams. So yeah, I guess he's still fine in the end. But you would, I think it's easier to just take out one Mewtwo and one Malamar, than take out two Mewtwos.
Yeah, for sure. Todd went down to one Shrine of Punishments, if I'm not mistaken, though, in his list. So he definitely went for like a way more straightforward approach. And yeah, this
There's a
Chaotix will.
Chaotix well.
Yep.
That's really, really good to stop Shrine of
Exactly.
Punishment
So no
since.
damage modifiers for Todd. I'll quickly check his list. And oh yeah, he does play two Shrine of Punishment still. So yeah, it's pretty close to what he used to play, what he used to win the Malmo Regionals. But he did take out the Acrobikes and went for more money and more energy spinner basically. And he also
There's
like
a chaotic order from Todd's opponent. It's really interesting. Using that GX attack right there to
Ooh.
take two prize cards and flip the rest of
Oh
them
yeah,
right
that makes
open.
sense. So it's over.
Yeah.
Yeah, now it makes a lot of sense. The opponent saw that there was the Den on board, so he Venom shot the one Zacian last turn, and then now he could just Chaotic Order take two prizes, and there was still the Den he could take out for the game. And yeah, Todd Ratcliffe's going down at 5-2 now after losing to back to back to Malamar Mewtwo, and this deck that seemed to fall out of the meta quite a lot is now climbing back, it seems.
Yeah, it's slowly falling back into favor because you have like a lot of options and you can go a lot of different routes with the deck. Maybe build players have found a way to build it more consistently, or just play it in different way, like play it in a way that makes the ADP Zacian matchup really, really good, as we saw in this case. But of course, taught with the altered creation,
Yeah, that was
so.
very unfortunate as well. And I heard against Nico, he also ran into a situation where Nico used Horror House and Todd just drew like all trainers out because I think he used Horror House for two and then Todd drew like all trainers and got knocked out the next turn from Poltergeist. So very unfortunate games. And however, Malamar Mewtwo has been running very smoothly here. So I think players probably went for a more consistent approach these days. Back in the day, when it kind of got hyped in the beginning of the new set, because and of the rule changes, because you could go for Horror House turn one, and then turn two you could go for Night Watch, and I assume people are figuring out that this combination just doesn't work very. Yeah, you can't really rely on this combination, so they are just making sure that they have other win options and are just using this combination as kind of a win, more like a bonus, like donking your opponent.
Yeah, the Gaslotner gun really came in pretty clutch, allowing you to just take two prize cards and forcing your opponent to play around that, right? Your opponent can't just force you to play a 7-prize game if you or 8-prize game if you have that option available to you in the later stages.
Yeah, and like, it's really cool to see that, because one of the big strengths of Mewtwo decks is always this GX attack, because Mewtwo can just copy any GX out there, so you have big pool of great GX Pokemon to choose from, and those GX attacks can be really powerful. So the Malamar Mewtwo deck, however, usually used to like burn the GX attack turn one just to slow down the opponent a little bit. And yeah, it felt like the GX wasn't that strong in this deck, so just adding more options with this Nagana Little Gaslord, and yeah, of course always having like Pale Moon, stuff like that available, it's really cool to see that the deck is going into a way of including more options and being more versatile.
Yeah, I agree with that for sure.
Anyways, that was it from round number 7. I'm glad that we got another game after that quick donk we saw, and I hope you enjoyed it, even though it wasn't like the most exciting game ever. Still was kind of nice to see, and definitely very well played from the Malamar player's side. And yeah, we will go to a quick break and we'll be back with round number 8 hopefully soon.